whenever you look at election reform, the idea is of integrity of the ballot. And whenever you have integrity of the ballot, people say, well, my vote does count. It will make a difference if I go and vote, and every vote could swing the election. And so that is critically important to have that kind of integrity at the ballot box, in our systems, to have people have confidence in it. And whenever we can build that, we're going to build and strengthen our democracy. What erodes confidence in our elections is simply that whenever they see fraudulent activity, and that could be by people who are not qualified voting, or they vote the cemetery, they vote the phone book, that obviously destroys the integrity of it, and that really undermines the entire democratic process. We want people to vote, and if we can make it easier, terrific. More convenient to the person that's working in the factory. Make sure they have that access. They can work, they can cast their vote according to their schedule. So that's an important part of election reform. The other part is the integrity side. And we have to give that same factory worker confidence that his or her vote is going to count, and that someone else that might be fraudulently voting or a fictitious name is not going to cancel their vote out. That's what I'm passionate about, to make sure that every person who votes is entitled to vote and that they're not going to illegally vote. We believe that elections should be run by the government. And so if you have private dollars all of a sudden coming in, being targeted to a particular jurisdiction or population, then all of a sudden the fairness in the entire election is in doubt. And so we did a prohibition on private dollars coming in to influence an election in that way. It's a governmental function. We're going to manage it. We're going to pay for it. And we're not going to allow private dollars to influence the fairness of an election. This is one of the most important reforms that we accomplished in Arkansas.